Welcome back. We are at episode 6, and unfortunately this is the last in our series on Swiss SuperLuminova. We've saved the best to last. We're talking about Lumicast today. Welcome. My name is Steve Mansfield. I'm one of the co-founders of SNGLRTY Watch, and we're joined today by Albert Zeller. He is the CEO of Luminova AG, based in Switzerland. Don't forget, please hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, put all your comments and questions below. We love to receive them. We love to know what you're thinking, what you need to know. It helps us understand what direction to head in. It's great to have your participation. You can join us at blog.singularity.watch. Don't forget, drop all the vowels when you're doing Singularity, S-N-G-L-R-T-Y, or visit us at singularitywatch.com, S-N-G-L-R-T-Y-W-A-T-C-H.com. We're on Facebook, we're on Twitter, we're on Instagram, and we're on LinkedIn. So head over there, subscribe to our channel, and please press the like button. All the algorithms love it when you press our like button, and we hope you've enjoyed this series of SuperLuminova. We hope that it's increased your understanding of the product. It certainly helped me understand this product much better going forward. So, Albert, thank you very much. You've been very patient with us. You've taken us through a lot of the details. Now we want to, you know, we've looked at some of the practical applications of how we apply the SuperLuminova. You've obviously got years of experience. The company's got years of experience of helping their clients to apply Luminova, and during that period of time, you've obviously seen a few mistakes. So what are the most common mistakes that you see when you see Luminova on watches, and you scratch your head and you think, maybe that wasn't such a good idea?
The application process is really something which has a big influence of the performance afterwards. So it starts maybe with the construction of the luminous deposit. If someone says, okay, I would like to have an engraving of 50 micrometers instead of 300 micrometers, for example, you destroy your luminous performance already in advance, because you cannot change anymore if the index, for example, is already produced. And afterwards, for example, also while printing, you can print a very narrow layer, maybe like with the thickness of one grain. But you, out of that luminous deposit, you will never have as much light as out of a thick printing, for example. It's just physical boundaries which you cannot overcome. Same with the colors.
Yeah.
So therefore, really create a lot of space to put the pigments in, and then it will also be really high performing.
Now, as I said in the introduction there, Lumicast, this is a new-ish product for you. You've had it around for a couple of years, is my understanding. And it seems to be the ultimate solution for people who love bright, luminous effect on their watch face. Can you tell us about Lumicast, how it's created and how it's used?
Actually, it's not that complicated. You've probably been also playing around with your kits at the beach, eh? Where you have like a little pot, yeah, where you put sand in. So Lumicast actually works in the same process to be constructed. You need a positive, and from this positive you take a mold. That mold is usually made with silicone. So then you have like the pot where you fill in the sand. In our case, yeah, it's filled with SuperLuminova, highly concentrated, only a little bit of binder. And then that build-up mold is dried, hardened, rectified, that it's completely flat, and then transferred to the watch component, taken out, and you have the piece on top. It opens quite a lot of new possibilities. Usually, if you've been doing printing until now, a printing will always look a little bit roundish from the side, a little bit an elevated center, whereas at the border, the paint is not that high. Whereas if you do a molded piece, you can really create rectangular shapes, for example, or you can even give it a diamond shape, for example. Things like that are possible. Maybe you can see also, if I hold this into the camera, there's a certain layer thickness.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. That's the advantage, because talking of thicker layers of the volume on the side, which is also created, you can also increase the luminous performance. That's right. One thing. And it's also a design element. If you can start working with different dimensions, this can also look quite nice in practical use.
Is there a minimum size that you can make these Lumicast pieces?
I would say at minimum it should be around 200, 250 micrometers. And then there's no maximum, but probably you don't want to have a watch case which is like 30 centimeters high. So,
are the Lumicast pieces themselves, do they have structural integrity, or are they very delicate?
This can be rather highly influenced by the binder system. If you don't use a little bit rigid binder system, you can also give it a certain flexibility.
How would you typically attach each Lumicast piece to the watch face?
Usually they're glued onto the dial.
Yeah.
Because the mold itself can directly be transferred to the dial, mm-hmm. rather high precisely. And then you just have it on top, you glue it, and you unmold it directly on the dial, for example. Yeah. Otherwise, another possibility is, we've been doing like some prototypes with that you can create feet underneath. And
that's
these feet
asking.
Are like regular indexes fixed. But also there, the feet, the drillings in the dial have to be a little bit bigger. Otherwise, it's hard to get in there. We've even done some trials where we put metallic feet into the liquid mold, mm-hmm. hardened the whole thing, transferred it so that you can even rivet it.
Albert, thank you very much for your time. You've been extremely generous. You've taken us through the SuperLuminova from start to finish, and certainly I've learned a lot. I hope our viewers have learned a lot as well. What I'd like to do is take a little bit of time to acknowledge you and acknowledge your colleagues at Luminova AG. I know that Luminova AG is a family company. It was started by your great-grandfather. And I believe he was probably more involved with radioactive materials back when he started the company, but that desire to continuously drive for innovation is still clearly at the fore of everything that you do at Luminova. We've had a great time, certainly Daniel and I, when we were developing our watch and developing SNGLRTY. There was a great deal of support that you and your team provided, and we're very grateful for that, and we're very grateful for the support that you provided to us as small watch entrepreneurs. So for that, I'd like to acknowledge you, I'd like to acknowledge your team, and have a big thank you very much for making this possible.
We're a family company. So in total, we're 21 people.
Mm-hmm.
Three of my family are even involved in the company. And maybe the spirit is also a little bit less, let's say, industrial, more family style. We can talk with each other. We try to also have a familiar and a friendship-based relationship with our partners. We don't like to call them customers, because at the end, we partner up from both sides, and this works quite well. The honest exchange, trying to help each other. Yeah,
that's it. We've been through the Luminova series now. I hope that it has been illuminating, brought a little bit more light to the your understanding of luminous materials, how they're applied to watches, what to be aware of to ensure that you get the best quality result when you're selecting your watch, or even if you're a little bit like Daniel Nine, you're a watch designer or a watchmaker, some of the key points to look out for. I've thoroughly enjoyed doing this. Once more, thank you very much to Albert Zeller for joining us and providing us with information from the front line, as it were. We've got plenty more of these lined up for different subjects. So if you enjoyed it, please do subscribe to our channel. Please join us on our social medias. We're on Facebook, LinkedIn, Instagram, and Twitter. But best of all, if you head over to our blog at blog.singularity.watch, don't forget, drop all the vowels, or at singularitywatch.com, sign up to our newsletter and you will get everything as it's released. We hope you enjoyed it, and don't forget, see time differently.